His name was Brian Bantry, and he became a Broadway producer with his capital that he accumulated. Oh my. There's just a few more of these. These are a menu of methods that can be substituted for standard academic curriculum, the most of which, in fact, the standard academic curriculum can sit right on top of. You don't have to be mutually exclusive when you do these things. Experiences with solitude. I knew from reading and from my own life that without the ability to be alone by yourself, that you're in for quite a substantial amount of grief in your life if you don't learn to appreciate your own company. But you're also missing, I think, one of the developmental steps in having a reflective mind, because the answers that come quickly, or the answers that come to you through brainstorming with other people, are not always, but most always, exceedingly shallow takes on whatever the question at hand is. You know, they may seem satisfying as they happen, but as you try to apply them, they're very often unsatisfactory. So you have to put yourself through, I don't think I'm telling most of you something you don't already know, you have to put yourself through a kind of an apprenticeship of solitude to break out of the box, to break out of ordinary thinking, even if it's high-level ordinary thinking. It's a trap. But how to trick children, and that I have to admit, how to trick children into doing something that I knew they needed to have practice with. Well, here are some of the ways. There's a reservoir system around New York City that goes from 10 or 15 miles away from the city to really 150 miles from the city, that supplies the water through an elaborate system of aqueducts and tunnels. And all of those reservoirs are wonderful places to fish, because no one fishes there. You get a permit from the city of New York. I don't think it costs anything. And you can fish in any of these reservoirs. I had a standing offer that anybody could take the day off and go fishing if they went alone, and that I had maps on the walls of where to go, and another day to get down to City Hall and get a permit to go fishing. When I used to do that, it was just pro forma. You know, you filled out some form and they handed you a permit to fish in the reservoirs. Huge fish, because of the, nobody fishes there. And the reservoirs around New York City are enormous. I mean, there'll be 5,000 acre lakes and impoundments that are 10, 15, 20 miles long. So they're real lakes. That's one way. Taking a hike. You want to get out of City Hall and try to get in and see the mayor, or just watch the city council, which is a slam dunk. You can just do that. Okay with me. You got to walk from my school to City Hall was about 10 miles. If that seems like an inordinately long walk to you, then welcome, I guess, to the 20th and 21st century. That would be a jaunt, historically, for people who wanted to get around. We've lost the use of our legs, and we've certainly lost, I think, the confidence that if you just put one foot in front of another, sooner or later, you'd be in California. And not that much later. So that's another way I arrange solitude. You could always go anywhere in the city and map a future place that someone might want to visit. You could go to the court area and map the location of the courts and the entrances and so on. Or you could go up to Columbia University and create a map of that campus that a kid could use with a little bit of acting ability to just walk on and live as a college student. We never got picked up doing that, and there must not have been a day when some of my kids weren't sitting in on law school lectures. They're all 13. Did they have any trouble passing as 19 or 20? No. I just told them, don't ever smile. Use a clipboard instead of a notebook. And strike arrogant poses. I said, you'll pass as a college student. The last three things I kept as colors on the palette, or the last two, were utterly independent study, not where I participated in the creation of a menu of alternatives, but where the kid from start to finish conceived the expedition and conceived the way to judge it. And finally, experience in how to kill time. I call it improvisational play. You got 3 hours to wait for your job interview. You're out on the winter beach at Coney Island. There's nobody else there, but there are waves, there are birds, there's sand as far as the eye can see, and no people. You know, how do you fill these bits of time? Because you're always afraid of, you see this as a cousin to solitude. If you're always afraid of doing these things by yourself, then you become lifelong dependent. You're one of those people who can't be seen on the street without a cell phone, and I would cheerfully murder you if I thought I could get away with it. Okay, those are the 12 action themes of what I call the guerrilla curriculum. If you would like to operate as a guerrilla inside the or underneath the radar of the government system, these are 12 ways to do it. Over the 11 years since I retired from school teaching, this will be, we're into the 12th, I had to find a way to distill the lessons that 30 years of classroom school teaching taught me. And for want of something better to do, I began writing books and going on an endless lecture tour, which has really taken me around the world, but it's taken me into every corner of the United States. The books that I've written during that time are all still in print, and they're available at my website, which I believe I told you was my name with the three W's and .com, or they're actually available from Barnes & Noble, but I'll sign them if you order them from the website.